Hey everyone, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In my channel, you will find videos about Dubai, traveling and wristwatches. In today's video, I'm trying several watches in Dubai's luxurious watch boutiques that caught my interest. I'm curious about your feedback, your favorite model out of my selection, and which one you would advise me to buy. If you like the video, I would be super happy if you would subscribe to my YouTube channel. So lean back and enjoy the video. Since I got more into wristwatches, I really like the brand Zenith. The El Primero is the most popular watch and definitely a stunner. Unfortunately, the 42mm always seems too big for my wrist. The 42mm black ceramic coated watch looks a little bit smaller than the normal polished cases, so I thought I could give it another try on my 16-inch wrist. Also, I love the panda or Mickey Mouse dial. Still, I think it is a little bit too big due to the long lugs. Next, we have the 38mm Zenith El Primero, the smaller brother of the 42mm. The watch looks very nice in size, but would be way better with a 20mm watch strap in my opinion. The 18mm looks a little bit too feminine for my taste. Now we come to the more modern Zenith, the DeFi collection. I selected my three favorite pieces. The classic with skeletonized dial, with leather strap and metal bracelet, and also one version with a ceramic case and a rubber strap. The version with metal bracelet looks actually surprisingly good and feels very comfortable. What holds me back here is the fact that it looks too similar to my Explorer, and I would like to have a watch that gives more contrast to my collection. The version with leather strap is a disappointment for me. I think the strap looks quite cheap and not as nice as the Hublot straps, which I normally love. This one is too shiny and looks more like artificial leather and not like the natural one. I'm not sure if it looks usually like this or if other ones are on a higher quality level. Last but not least, we have the ceramic version, which I really like. The black housing looks super cool and the rubber strap is very comfortable. Unfortunately, this version has the highest price and seems to offer the smallest value. Also, I'm not sure how a ceramic case will behave in the long run. I mean, a normal stainless steel case you can always polish if you're annoyed by the scratches. But with the ceramic housing, you won't be able to do so. So I'm not sure if I would be so happy with that. After the Zenith watches, we move on with Hublot. Out of all Hublot watches, I really like the Classic Fusion and nearly bought one already. I think the watch case looks very cool with the screws and this bullseye design. The strap now feels very comfortable and looks very luxurious. What holds me back of the Hublot is the classic Sellita movement with, in addition, high maintenance costs at Hublot for such a movement. The 42mm, I think, looks perfect on my wrist. Now we come to our all-time star Rolex. As I own already one sports model, I'm thinking about getting another date just in addition. My favorite would be the 41mm with the grey dial, Romanian numerals and a two-tone Jubilee bracelet. Besides that, the 36mm white gold Jubilee and black dial looks nice as well. With the Rolex, I would probably have the best value increase. Or let's say, no big value loss at all. What you often find in Dubai, out of the few available sports models, is the Yachtmaster Platinum. I like the thin case of this watch, but the polished center links are not really appealing to me. Also, the watch is on the upper end of my budget and I'm not sure if I want to add another sports model, as I would wish for more versatility in my collection. Now we come to a little bit lower price range, which contains the Hamilton Intramatic chronograph. As I said in the beginning, I love panda dials, and this watch definitely nails it for me. The color, dimensions, and shape of the panda dial is absolutely perfect in my opinion. I don't know any watch that comes close to it. On the downside, this watch is very thick with nearly 15 millimeters, what I don't like about it. Actually, I hate thick watches. Also, the lug seems to be quite long. Besides the panda version, Hamilton offers an amazing looking blue version. I really like both versions, but probably the panda dial with a dark brown strap would be my winner if the case wouldn't be that thick. Last but not least, we have the Tudor with the Black Bay GMT. Due to my travels, I'm always appealed by GMT watches. As a Rolex GMT Master is nearly impossible to get, as I won't pay over retail, I checked out the Tudor as an alternative. Unfortunately, the watch again feels too big for my wrist and seems quite bulky, besides the overall nice look, in-house movement and nice features. Actually, here you get a lot of watch for the price. So this is my pre-selection for the moment. What do you think? Which is your favorite and which watch would you advise me to get? Let me know in the comments and hopefully see you in one of my next videos. Thanks a lot and bye bye.